Folks, scrambled O checking in. Quick video for you guys today. Figured it'd be a beautiful day to get outside and show you guys my pack. I got a new pack and a lot of other new gear recently, so I figured it was a decent time to get out and show you guys my new bushcraft kit. So guys, thanks for watching. All right. Well, first thing you'll notice is I got a new pack recently. This is the Frost River Summit Expedition pack, and it is nice. Ever since I laid my eyes on the Frost River brand, I really like the look of them, and I always wanted to buy one. I got a good deal on it from a friend of mine. So I pulled the trigger and bought it, and I haven't regretted it. It is an amazing pack. They're well built. They're canvas and leather. They got that old school look to them. You want something that's strong, good tough material, robust, well built, and that's exactly what you get with Frost River. Up top, it's got these nice leather squares where you can attach your bedroll to the top, run in a piece of cordage or a leather strap through these, so you can carry a bedroll on the top. Look at this thing. I mean, it is freaking awesome. I love this pack. Just looking at the details. Oh man. Yeah, I really loved it. For me, this pack's perfect. The design's perfect. It's just one big open bucket inside, and then it's got these two pouches on the side that fit water bottles, and then a pouch on the front. Yeah, it's probably about 30 liters. I've got everything packed in here except for food and my bedroll. Those two things would fit in here, and like I said, on the top and on the bottom of the pack, there's an area for the bedroll. I'm gonna go through the pack and show you everything that I keep inside of it. This right here is a sweatshirt, and it represents the space in my pack that I dedicate for clothing. Next up is my mess kit. This is my Coleman aluminum mess kit. It's probably the oldest piece of kit I have, and I don't need another one because this is perfect. This kit's got a top and a bottom. You can use the top as a lid or as a little bowl or a cup. The only downside to this kit was it didn't have a bale. So basically all I had to do was drill a few holes in each side, and now I have a bale to hang it over a fire. And having that versatility or flexibility with your kit just makes it that much better. Inside of this, I tend to keep a couple packets of coffee, a wire scrubby so I can clean my dishes, some seasoning, and a little wooden spoon to eat with. Next up, this is kind of like my first possibles pouch. This is a little pouch I sewed up a few months back, and what I use this for is to carry around just some odds and ends. So I got a nice big old piece of fatwood, a crook knife. I think this is a Mora crook knife for spoon carving. I've also got a flex cut knife for fine carving, getting that extra detail in to when you're doing spoons or any other type of carvings. I also keep a hank of jute twine in there just for extra cordage or for fire starting. In the back side of the pack, there's a pocket for back support. So what I keep in there is a little pad that I can kneel on. I have an extra pad, so two pads, and a little wood cutting board. And in the back, I also keep my field strop. This is a new knife I got recently. This is the Adventure Sworn Walker. It's a small little knife. It's a neck carry. This is the first time I've ever done a neck carry, and I like it. Yeah, it's a nice, it's like an ivory micarta with black liners, Scandi grind, and as you can see, it's a pretty small knife. I mean, it's definitely taken some adjusting to get used to, but I like it, man. I really like it. What else I got in here? All right, in terms of sleeping setup, I usually use a hammock. So what I've got in here is my Eno Atlas straps and my Eno double nest hammock. I also keep like a clear mesh baggie full of all my cordage. I've got bank line, regular paracord. I've got it in fluorescent orange, camo, black, just different colors. And here's the tarp that I've been using. It's a 10x10 Bushcraft Outfitters Coyote tarp, nylon I think. And yeah, it packs down pretty small. And last but not least is the full possibles pouch. I keep a variety of items, stuff called tenacious tape, basically like a tarp repair tape. I have this, which is a Luminade solar chargeable lantern. You blow it up. And once you blow it up, it creates almost like a little inflated pillow, and there's a light inside. Next up is a lighter. Keep an extra lighter and my headlamp in the possibles pouch. Also a small little field notes journal in case there's ever anything I need to jot down. Pen to write with. Also I've got four tent stakes. Also I keep in my possibles pouch my water purification kit, which is a black bandana to help filter the water. And then I've got the Sawyer Mini setup right here. Last but not least, I keep a pair of gloves in there. Keep a nice pair of gloves. It's helpful to have around the fire if you're moving firewood or you're lifting hot pots up out of the coals or just for woodworking and stuff. It's nice to have a little bit of extra protection sometimes so you don't get blisters.
All right, on the side of the pack, these little side pockets that are perfect for a water bottle. On this side, I keep my Silky Gomboy and a couple of books. On the other side, you guys have probably seen this quite a bit on the channel. This is my Gransfors small forest axe. And yeah, this thing gets a lot of use. I love this thing. And yeah, this is just a beautiful tool. Basically a very small axe or a long hatchet. It's perfect for wood processing. Last thing I keep in the side pouches is my water bottle. This is just like a Pathfinder 1 liter water bottle with a nesting cup. Simple. And the last pouch is this front pouch. And what I keep in here is my tender pouch. And this is perfect for collecting tender that you want to keep dry, or you could use it as a food bag. Also, keep my first aid kit, which is basic first aid stuff, as well as my hygiene kit, toilet paper, toothpaste, a couple ibuprofen, wet wipes, stuff like that. Just basic first aid kit. And also, last but not least, the fire steel. Keep the fire steel in the front pocket. That way I know where it is, rather than it get lost inside of that big possibles pouch. I keep it right up here up front. Makes it easy to get. This kit is everything I need to go out into the woods for a day or two. Like I said earlier though, I don't have my bedroll, which is either a sleeping bag or some type of blanket, and I don't have my food. I just want to do a quick video showing you guys the contents of my bushcraft kit. Got a couple of new toys recently, so I figured I'd show them off to you guys. Alright guys, that wraps up this video. It was just a quick video on my bushcraft kit. Got some new toys recently, I figured it'd be a good time to show them off. I appreciate you guys watching, and until next time, Scrambledo signing off.